Take a statement from coach and then questions.
Good, fun college basketball environment. I thought the fans were all standing and the crowd was great. It got really loud in there, you know, and I was proud of our guys. You know, we were a little off, didn't quite have for stretches tonight, but you know, they kept battling to the very end, which I was proud of.
Questions?
Coach, I know it's still relatively early in this season. Are you necessarily worried at all about sliding in the Big Sky rankings after this loss?
No, I mean, it's a marathon. You know, we're going to be just fine. You know, for us, it's a process. We just keep getting better and clean things up every game, and that's what it's about. At the end of the day, it's not going to be one game, or they all count one at the end of the day. And for us, I think it's just about continuing to get better. We got to get a little healthier too. I think we're running on fumes at times, and some guys are banged up. We got to get some quality practices, and I mean, that's hard to do when you're just trying to keep guys game ready. But that's okay. That's part of what this market is.
Harrison, this is for you and Coach. If you want to answer this as well. In the second half, Harry, they put Bassett on you, and outside of the charge call that you got, it seems like you guys really liked that matchup. What did you guys see in that matchup? You went at him consistently to the basket and even popped out head free.
Coach trusted me to do what I could do, and that's what I did. I attacked his feet and just did what I could do, made him play, and the more I did, the more he trusted me, and just kept at me.
Yeah, Coach, what
do
you see in that
match? Yeah, I mean, Harris is playing at a high level right now, you know, and he's really hard to keep in front of. He's crafty offensively, makes the right plays, and so we like the matchup, you know, really just about anybody, but especially, teams with size on him, and so that's a good deal for us. And put small on him, we like him to post. And so he's coming on, and there's a reason why he's on his way to being a 1,000-point scorer here. You know, he's a major weapon for us, and it will be a big key for us down the stretch here.
Do you have any? Harrison, what's it feel like? You know, you have those few big baskets. You see people in the crowd doing your little signature thing. What's that feeling like for you?
I'm a big student section guy, so their energy, I feed off it a lot, and I think the team sometimes feeds off my energy, so. Them cheering, them making fun of the other team, you know, cheering for us, telling jokes. I love it. I love the environment. It helps me play better, gets my energy up, and gets my teammates up too.
Coach, in the first half, Tevin Jones was held scoreless. In the second half, he seemed like an entirely different player, more energized, more focused. Was a big part of that 18-4 run throughout the year. We've seen him take a step back in terms of production. I'm sure that's part of the year that he had last year and the accolades that he got in the offseason. What adjustments have you seen defenses make to his game, and what have you tried to see him do to counteract those changes that they've made?
Yeah, tough one for him today. You know, we were ahead with him in the game, and he just picks up the second foul with 10 minutes left in the half. You know, so we kind of sit him out that last 10 minutes and not risk getting a third, especially, we were a little worried about some of the touch fouls that are kind of getting called, so we had to kind of play that by feel, which obviously takes him off the floor for that 10-minute stretch. He's plus 7 for the game. We sure would have liked to have him on the floor those other 11 minutes. But that's the nature of foul trouble, and we just do the best we can with it.
Coach, it seemed like there might have been some issues switching defensively, keeping up with all the motion on offense. I know you guys just played Saturday, a quick turnaround. Think it's a kind of a product of not having much rest in between games, or is that something you feel like this team needs to work on defensively?
Yeah, we weren't great defensively, and I think some of that too. I mean, John's trying to play through some injuries, and to his credit, he gave us 35 and a half minutes, and he's probably 50% at the best, I would say, and that's tough. You know, that's a tough deal, and you get some stretches, T gets in foul trouble, and Dre gets a little foul trouble start to have in the second half, and you get a little tentative. You know, I think that impacts what you do defensively, but we'll clean some of that stuff up. I mean, Weber's a good team, and they did a good job, and they came in here and made shots, and they did some things that guys stepped up and had big games for them.
Finally for me, Coach, Siku Sososo, Jalari, and Kobe McEwen hit big shots all night. late in that first half or in the second half when they built that big lead, after you guys came back and made it close, they, you know, kind of closed you guys out there. What makes them so difficult to guard?
Well, just their ability to make shots. I mean, Juwar was 5 for 6 from three, and you know, McEwen's just such a, they're both physical guards, and they, you know, they today they were really sharing the ball. I mean, we were going to try to make them kind of be passers, and today they were making the right reads, which made you have to change your coverage just a little bit. And to their credit, they did a lot of good things.
All right, thank you guys.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.